Adulterers and adulteresses, do you not know that friendship with the world is enmity with God? Whoever therefore wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. You don't want to be an enemy of God. Why would you want to be an enemy of God? That means hellfire. Hellfire. Eternal hellfire. Without God, you're nothing but a speck of dust on the ground. It's filthy rags that God has to clean up. Wow, you clean up before God has to do it himself. Because he only sees you as filthy rags. Let him wash your sin away. Let Jesus wash your sin away before it's too late. Repent. Why are you even in there? You don't want to be an enemy of God. Who wants to be an enemy of God? No one truly wants to burn in hell. You can say all you want, but no one wants to. No one wants to burn in hell for eternity. It's nonsense. It's the devil trying to get into your head and fool you. You do not want to be an enemy of God. If you think that real judgment, but wait until you meet the real judge. That's execution. It's heaven or hell. Eternity. That's eternity. This is just tonight. This is just tonight. We're talking about eternity. Tonight you should repent. Tonight is the night to repent. Today is the day of salvation. Not tomorrow. Not next week. Not next month. It's today. It's tonight. Before it's too late. You don't want to make yourself more of an enemy of God than you already are. You're just a sinner. And you need repentance. You need Jesus. You need to read the Bible. You need to put down what you're doing and read the Bible before it's too late. Tonight could very well be your last night. You need to repent. Leave if you have to. Leave and pray and ask God for forgiveness. That's what you need to do. There's no other way out. Sin is sin. You can't call yourself a Christian and keep sinning. There's no other way out. God and Jesus and the Bible is the only way out of your sin. You can't do it by yourself. If you do it by yourself, you're going to struggle. Be perfect in Jesus. Be perfect through God. Be perfect in Jesus. You need repentance. You need the good fruit. Because this is only gentry. This is the rotten fruit. God doesn't want rotten fruit. He wants good fruit. Fruit of the Spirit. All you're doing is putting his forgiveness back in his face. Why did Jesus die on the cross for your sins? Now you're just putting it back in his face. What's the point? What are you even doing here tonight? All you're doing is making a mockery of God. If you leave and repent, well, you still have a chance. Tonight could be your last night. You never know. God could be knocking on your door. It sounds like a thief in the night. You never know. You'll never expect it. You have to repent before it's too late. Jesus said, if your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. He said, if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. Go to whatever causes you to sin, stop sinning and repent. Before it's too late. Before it's too late. You have to have good fruit. You have good fruit and bad fruit. You cannot call yourself a Christian and go into there. You cannot. You're a hypocrite if you do. Turn or burn. Repent or perish. Before it's too late. You never know. Why take the chance? Why even come out here to get sick? All you're doing is getting sick. You drinking until you can't drink anymore, but then you still keep drinking. What's the point? All you're doing is getting yourself sick. And it's a sin. Jesus said, go and sin no more. Change your life. Change your life before it's too late.